challenging the outcome of the January 14th elections, where she lost to NRM candidate Sylvia Nayebare for the position of a Gomba Woman Member of Parliament. We have the details in the following report. Betty Sentamu, who contested on the NUP ticket, once called to nullify the election of NRM Sylvia Nayebare, saying she was not validly elected and that the results declared by the Electoral Commission's Anne Ahebwa are null and void. Today, Nayebare's team of lawyers led by Geoffrey Kandebe raised preliminary objection against the petition, saying it failed to conform to the rules governing petitions, including non-payment of the full fees of 150,000 shillings. Kandebe went ahead to ask court to dismiss with costs this petition because it failed to follow the rules and that the deponents presented as affidavits failed to comply with the rules governing the Illiterates Protection Act.
The impugned petition has been dismissed because the petition did not conform or comply with the rules governing the presentation of petitions.
Justice Anthony Ojule Wawire agreed with the respondent's lawyer that it is true that the petitioner did not follow the rules governing the Illiterates Protection Act, and this therefore renders them false.
He read the document over the illiterate, for that he explained the illiterate the content of the document, and that in fact the illiterate, as a result of the explanation, understood the contents of the document.
Justice Wawire noted that while the petitioner's lawyer had asked court to enlarge the time to enable them pay the remaining 50,000 shillings balance, court wouldn't accept to bend the law over such a matter that was already settled in the law.
But you must pay 150,000. But for them, they didn't pay all the money. They decided to pay half of the money.
Sylvia Nayebare, who was present in court and keenly followed the proceedings in court, was excited after the ruling.
Also on their affidavits, out of 100%, practically 99% have been struck out by the judge. Yes, I'm very happy and excited. I am still the elected member of parliament.
Betty Sentamu and her lawyer said they are ready to appeal against the ruling once court avails them with the full version.
Just straight away to the court of appeal. It is not yet over until it is over.
We raised preliminary objections, which this honorable court has upheld.
Meanwhile, Jinja High Court has dismissed with costs an election petition against Kagoma County Member of Parliament Moses Waliomu Mwanika. Frederick Munyirwa, a candidate in the general elections, petitioned court asking it to nullify the nomination and victory of the respondent, but instead court upheld the status quo on grounds that the petitioner failed to prove his case. The petitioner went to court arguing that the first and second respondents connived to have a fraudulent election process that saw Waliomu declared the winner. He stood on grounds that the first respondent did not have the minimum academic qualifications to be nominated as a candidate, and the second respondent declared him illegally having participated in vote rigging, voter bribery, among other malpractices.
It was really a shock. But what I want to inform you today is that we've discussed shortly with our client and our instructions are to appeal to the next court. We believe in the next court we shall win this case.
Court presided over by Justice Joseph Murangira squashed the petition, saying the petitioner failed to prove to court beyond reasonable doubt with evidence to support his grounds.
Mr. Munyira Frederick and his witnesses had attempted to bring to court was simply forged to try and overturn the victory of Waliomu Moses, which reflected the will of the people of Kagoma County constituency.
I don't know whether I can even talk. I'm so happy with the judgment. they made the right choice. I'm with the Member of Parliament and I'm going to serve my people. I'm going to serve my people with all the due respect to my people.
Report by Simon Sechide and Ivan Lubega.